Welcome back, friends. Welcome to Talk Max English. I'm here with a new topic today, and the topic is we're going to talk about phrase today. As we have already talked about the sentence, we have talked about the clause. Today we take a new thing that's called the phrase. What exactly is a phrase? A phrase usually is two or more than two words that we use, a structure, a linguistic structure that we use to express an idea. But how do we understand it grammatically? How different is it from clause, or how different is it from a sentence? What exactly is a phrase? As I said, a phrase is a group of words that may convey some idea, but it's not a sentence. It's not a sentence, or for that matter, it's not even a clause. What is it that makes it different from a clause? It could be part of a sentence, but it cannot be a sentence. We use it to express an idea, but not it's not a sentence. Grammatically, it cannot be a sentence, a phrase. Why not? For example, if you remember, when we talked about a sentence, we said that it contains certain elements, certain existing elements. And then we talked about the clause. The clause also contains some existential elements that enable it at times to exist independently. But on the other hand, the phrase cannot exist independently, although in spoken English at times we use phrases to express certain ideas. But what exactly does a phrase mean? If you see here, if you look here, running fast to reach home early to help his parents. The words are in a proper sequence. There are so many words. So many words in a proper order, in a proper sequence. But still, it doesn't give a sense of completion. It doesn't satisfy the communication. If you remember, when we talked about sentence, I said there could be two words only that can make a sentence. For example, I said birds fly. It makes a sentence. Only two words can make a sentence. And here you have a group of words, so many words, but still in a proper order, in a proper sequence, but still not able to make a sentence. Now, this kind of structure, when the words are in a proper sequence and convey some sort of idea but don't give us the complete meaning, is usually a phrase. And then there is more, something more important that we have to understand, that how is it different from a clause. A clause, we have already said, that has its own subject and it has its own finite verb. While as a phrase does not have any of these, usually does not have any of these things, especially it does not have a finite verb. A phrase does not have a finite verb, and it usually does not have a subject as well. And hence, you have these words here in the sequence, running fast to reach home early to help his parents. That's all. That's all we have. And it does not give us complete meaning. We don't get what we call as that sense of completion. And if I add only two or three words to it, say, I say, running fast to reach home early to help his parents, he fell down. Now, if you see, it makes a complete sentence. What makes it into a complete sentence is the presence of this subject and the presence of this finite verb. So, what was missing in the phrase? Although a phrase, like a clause, is part of a sentence, it could be part of a sentence, but it cannot be a sentence. It can never ever exist independently as a grammatical complete structure. Why not? Because we know for a sentence, for a clause, we must in the first place have a subject, and we must have a finite verb. And in phrases, we usually do not have all these things. We don't have a subject, and we never ever have a finite verb when it comes to phrases. A phrase is a grammatical structure. The words are in a proper sequence. A phrase is part of a sentence, but it can never ever be independent. Although at times in spoken English, we use a phrase to express certain idea. So, a phrase is a part of a sentence, but unlike clause, it does not not have its own subject and it does not have its own finite verb. So if you ask me, what's a phrase? A phrase is a grammatical structure, a group of words that can be used to express a certain idea. But it cannot be a sentence. It's not a sentence at all. Why is it not a sentence? Because for the certain reasons, a sentence certainly has its own subject and it has its own finite verb. And it gives us that sense of completion. It gives you a complete meaning. While as in the phrase, the existential components are missing. That is the subject and the finite verb. And that's what makes it the phrase. A phrase, a group of words in a proper sequence, convey a certain idea, but not a sentence. And it's a part of a sentence, but not like clause. Because clause is a part of sentence that has its own subject and its own finite verb. But the phrase does not have, it neither has a subject or it does not have the finite verb. I hope you understand it, and I hope you are able to differentiate between a sentence and the clause and the phrase. Expecting you to keep watching our channel and keep subscribing to our channel. And if you have any questions, any doubts, you can always put your views, your opinion, your questions on our channel. Thank you very much, and see you in the next topic.